When people ask me where I'm from, I say, I'm from Palm Springs, California. Their response can be one of two ways. One, it's freaking hot over there. Or two, I don't know where that is. If they don't know where it is, I usually continue with, have you ever heard of Coachella Fest? Because that's where it's at. But I'm not here today to talk about Coachella Fest or Palm Springs specifically. I'm here to talk about the hidden gem of desert architecture. The Coachella Valley has served many years as inspiration for many architects in modern architecture who have defined the culture of the valley and with their work and have inspired me to become an architect. To get a better understanding of how important architecture is in the Coachella Valley, you must know exactly what the heck, where is Coachella Valley, what is modern architecture and how it's incorporated in the desert, and how it's impacted today in the valley. So, what and where is the Coachella Valley? It is a collection of 18 desert cities located east of Los Angeles, halfway between LA and Arizona. Before the 1920s, nobody really lived there until around air conditioning was made, and even then, the houses there were either made out of canvas, adobe, or wood. It wasn't until World War II happened that modernism began to make its appearance. So, what is modernism? Well, here are the basic characteristics of what modern architecture looks like. So, lack of ornaments, so everything's very minimalistic, there's not a lot going on, but it still looks very sophisticated. Rectangular forms, so they focus a lot on like boxes and simple geometric shapes. Low flat roofs, as you can see in this image, everything's low, it's a one-story house, the roof's flat, nothing's like going everywhere. And they mix modern, so like steel and concrete, and traditional materials like wood and bricks. And they focus on open flowing spaces, such as an open kitchen connecting into the living room. And they focus a lot on natural light and shading, so how the sun, as it moves through the day, how it interacts with the space that you're living in. According to Albert Stewart in his article, Desert Modernism, he quotes, "The sun-drenched landscape of this California city is a draw for the rich and famous and a magnet for the artists. An example of such famous architectural work by a famous architect is the Frank Sinatra House located in Palm Springs. As you can see, it is a very good example of exactly what modernism is. Everything's flat, you can big windows, bricks, and lots of glass. And it opens directly to the outside, everything's pretty open. But I think this quote from Liz Logan, who says it in her article, Desert Dreaming, quote, "The style is characterized by glass, clean lines, natural industrial materials, and bent of outdoor and indoor space is a much better explanation for desert modernism, because you get buildings like the Bob Hope House, which doesn't exactly follow the characteristics mentioned before, where it's rectangular form. As you can see, it's very curved, it's a massive building, actually. And it does have lots of windows, and it's open to the outside, but it doesn't exactly follow the basic modernist examples that I've shown. And then we also have other structures, like the Kellogg House, that's located in Joshua Tree. And as you can see, this is another big characteristic of desert architecture, where they like to mold the building in the landscape itself. So you can see the building kind of camouflages with the color of the sand that it's on, and then how the roof kind of is similar to the shape of the boulders that surround it. That is a key characteristic to desert architecture, as it likes to have it all blend in with the landscape. But as the turn of the century had been, modernism began to die down. But today, there have been a lot of efforts to conserve these historic monuments, such as the Kauffman House. Recently, it was about to be demolished because of really poor care for it, but a couple has recently taken it over and restored it back to its original, almost to its original 1946 design. An article titled Mod Mecca by M. Bruce states that Coachella Valley is a cradle of mid-century California architecture, and it is starting to regain its pre-recession vitality, riding a wave of interest not seen since the city's post-war days. And more recently, local architects like Trophy Architecture, who I had the pleasure of interning for in my senior year of high school, has begun to revive this modernist style and he's starting to bring more new buildings into the desert, as you can see in this Yucca Valley home. The Art newspaper states that they, quote, see the desert as not so blank canvas for a wider range of projects by leading artists. So it has brought in a lot of inspiration to artists nowadays, just as much as they did back then. So, the Coachella Valley has also become a very huge artistic hotspot. As every year for the past 10 years, we've had the Modernism Week, which is a week full that brings in 60,000 visitors to come tour the modernist architecture in Palm Springs. And more recently, the Mirror House, which is part of the Desert X exhibition that is a valley-wide four-month exhibition that happened this year. This is the most popular exhibit, and it has brought a lot of inspiration to architecture in the valley that has since been dying down. So, as you can see, the Coachella Valley is a prime hotspot for architectural buildings, historic architectural buildings. At first, it wasn't very developed, but after World War II, it has created Palm Springs, and the Coachella Valley is one of the most modern architectural condensed areas in the world. And today, as stated by Dee Dilworth in his architectural record article, quote, today the Coachella Valley is more of the is one of the fastest growing areas of California development. So maybe next time when you go to Coachella Fest, try to stop and look at the amazing architecture that surrounds the Coachella Valley. Thank you.